Hey, Alpha fam, welcome back to another episode of Alpha Commission. Today on Alpha Commission, of course, we're going to go over the continued red on the charts overall, but we do see many coins starting to pump based upon that support level, which we identified yesterday in the Trading Sunday video. Of course, we do have just some kind of meme coins, kind of poo coins, kind of popping off here, a little bit of front running on the rest of the market, which they tend to do with those kind of pump and dump type mentalities. Lunch just going for it. Really just a disgusting chain at this point. I don't think anyone really wants anything to do with Luna, but hey, you know, people will try to trade this stuff anyway. You know, you can see in the stock market, we did get a nice pump, which is good to see, but that really wasn't significant. And you can see that the market was highly risk off. You do see Amazon down, Google down, Microsoft down, Apple down, all of these tech sectors, of course, which we can consider crypto to be part of, down, risk off today. What we do see pumping, of course, is discount stores. Okay, that's not good, right? The energy market, that's not good for inflation, right? Discount stores suggest, you know, the recession fears, right? And then healthcare, why? Because it's very reliable, whereas all of these other ones are kind of a risk on. So you do see it is a risk off day. And what does that tell you, Alpha fam? What does that suggest to you? Use your minds. Think. What does that mean to you? It means that crypto isn't likely to be getting a big push out of that. Why? Because crypto is one of the most risk-on assets that there are in the market. And so if crypto is part of the risk-on market, then this type of pump in the stock market, yes, it can lift up crypto a little bit, but it's not likely to contribute to a direct run, at least not right now. And of course, all of this downturn was spurred by multiple factors, including the stock market being at its resistance line on the S&P 500 for that downtrend. And then also, of course, a bunch of the other indices had just broken trend to the upside, but it was a classic bear market fake out. And we did understand, you know, at least here at the Alpha Commission, we did have the understanding that we do have to retest the lows at a minimum in order to have any type of confirmation in this market. And possibly these risk on assets like crypto could even make a lower low, even if some of these more reliable stocks might be starting to find a floor. You know, we're just gonna have to see how things shuffle around. We're gonna have to see how things settle coming to the end of the year, right? So we're just getting started, guys. But I do think that we are in the last phase of this downturn, and that should get a lot of people excited, even if a bear market does keep us sideways. And just to show you what's going on, it's been a while since I've shown the good old Alpha Origin channels. So let's just throw those on and look at this. We're getting a nice double bottom on the Alpha Origin channels. This, of course, is Alpha because I created it. It's the Alpha Commission, basically a set of Origin channels that I set up months and months ago. Almost a year ago, I started plotting this out, and then you know, it basically became fixed about you know, a little bit over half a year ago, and it has been incredibly reliable in terms of this just a warning for a breakdown level, right? We were able to get out of the market here, not here, because we saw the breakdown from this mid channel of this kind of a purple overheated zone. Of course, we sold everything at the top of the market around $59,000 to $60,000. And so we really got out at this overheated level. And then, of course, was warning everyone to get out at this, you know, $50,000. Let's just say, $47,000 level, and then just screaming our heads off over here at the Alpha Commission, you know, this is your last chance, get out, we're going to enter the capitulation phase. And of course, we just had a straight drop from there, which is consistent with past behavior and how price has moved along these diagonal alpha origin channels. And then, of course, we found support on this white line. The white line does indicate where the final stages of capitulation have, at least in the last couple mid cycles and full cycles, have occurred. And so that was likely to front run as a signal. Breaking that white line was likely to front run a catastrophic drop, and that's exactly what we saw. So the Alpha Commission, over here, we've been just ahead of the curve on this entire game. Got out, when we turned from pink to a purple over here, just entirely got out of the market during that transition zone right there in this kind of no man's land where there's just kind of a gap here. And then, of course, we've just been warning everyone else ever since. And then what have we come to? Well, we've come, of course, down to my bloodline, and my bloodline is where the market has basically been bled to death. And so this represents just an extremely good value zone. Anytime you're touching this, alpha origin channel's bloodline, right, that is a good time to start considering your positions for the bottom of the market. And you can see we front ran this bloodline a little bit up here, no problem, right? We broke through it down here, no problem. Maybe we're going to break through it again. There's a high likelihood of it. You guys know my position. I think that we could come all the way down to this green line, right? Something like $8,000, $9,000, and then worst case situation, maybe $5,000 if this is just a global, macro commodities super cycle, not the bullish super cycle that idiots like Crypto Banter were talking about, where they thought we were going to go to $200,000 and, at least $100,000. That was all complete BS made up by market makers and corrupt people on the inside trying to liquidate you right as the market was about to turn around. But what I'm talking about is a stocks, a commodities, a global commodities super cycle where we could end up at very, very low levels. However, I highly recommend you watch my Macro Monday video that I put out earlier today. That should give you an idea of just how close we're getting to the bottom, because we are starting to see signals fire, which would suggest that we are not only in very good value zones, but in fact that we could be even at the bottom, or that the next macro low, wherever it ends up being, whether it's right here, whether it's right here, whether it's right here, wherever the next macro low takes us, right, that could end up being the bottom of the market as long as it holds through winter. And that's my condition. I want a final confirmation by the end of winter. Now, you guys know that these bear markets last months and months and months. They can go sideways for a year. They can go sideways for 6 months to a year, or even longer in some cases. Of course, this was diagonal, but Bitcoin was going parabolic in those early days, right? It started from like a couple cents, and then it went up to like $70,000 basically. So of course, there's this parabolic phase, but you can still see this sideways action that lasted, almost a year here, right? You can see this sideways action that lasted almost a half a year. You see this sideways action right here that lasted almost 1 year. And so there's a good chance that since we've only been going sideways here for about 3 months, that we could have a couple more months to maybe even half a year to a year of a more sideways action. right? Where maybe the price comes up a little bit on average, but we could have significant drops down. And then that's how we're going to get a confirmation of a accumulation at the bottom of the market. Now, the topic of today isn't really that macro perspective, but I did just want to touch base with the Alpha Origin channels because, of course, we are seeing this very lovely just a diagonal double bottom. And guys, this chart was made months and months ago, but look at this beautiful touch here. Look at this beautiful touch here. Nice clean bounce off of that. And, I couldn't be prouder of this system. This system has saved a lot of people's butts who've been watching this channel. This system saved my butt because it allowed me to control my emotions and have this kind of zoomed out perspective, but with guidelines, right? With guidelines that other people, that other channels just were not able to provide, as they kind of flailed around emotionally day to day, we had our eye on the prize, which was this bloodline. And guys, we are here again. If you missed your chance here, we are here again. And I don't want to be, too bullish right now because the macro does have a lot of negative things going against it. But you can see that as we travel along in this channel, in this kind of no man's land between the blue zone and this bloodline, that we do tend to move the bottom of the price up along this line. And look, guys, look, it's happening again. If you didn't buy in at this bottom with us when we got into the market and traded this amazing bull run that we had, right? 40% on the Bitcoin chart, 40% run up, guys. We traded that from basically the bottom of my bloodline, then, well, look, you've got another chance. Of course, you may never get the price as low as what we got previously, but then again, this line could break down. This is a very ugly look on the chart right now. This looks like a bear flag that could potentially take us lower. And while I don't want to be calling anything, exactly, but you can see that this, this range is, pretty reasonable. If we did hit down here, maybe 14,000, maybe kind of a double bottom at 16,000, maybe even 11,000 to that kind of 10,000 zone, this whole green area, right? This kind of touching the grass, if you will, right? For Bitcoin, especially after this macro double top, that wouldn't be weird. That would be perfectly consistent with what you saw here with us hovering above the bloodline, pushing down through the bloodline. And if we push down even deeper after having this rounded kind of top as opposed to a blow-off top, after having a double top as opposed to a blow-off top, then that would make perfect sense as this asset is slowly turning over. And so while we are definitely going to have a great next cycle, these cycles are starting to round. Their tops are getting less toppy and their bottoms are getting a little bit deeper. Okay, so let's just watch out for that. We are on, on watch for a macro low, and that's something that we should have high interest in. Please watch my Macro Monday video. I'm saying this for your benefit. I don't get any type of ad revenue. Nobody's paying me anything. I don't have commercials that pay me any type of commission or anything like that. I'm saying it for your benefit. Please watch the Macro Monday video that I put out. And guys, if we zoom in, okay, and just turn off these good old Alpha Origin channels, which have just been so good to us and have been just so precise and just pinpoint perfect on these moves. Look at that bottom, drawn months and months in advance. Look at this support, okay? Like, I know guys brag about their horizontals, but I can really brag about my diagonals because, you know, I may not be the best at all of those, you know, horizontal supply and demand zones, you know, but on the diagonals, I'm pretty good, guys. And so let's just go ahead and turn those alpha origin channels off and just look at what we were actually facing on, you know, a trading Sunday. We had to defeat this momentum barrier at $20,250, and then to be bullish, $20,000, let's just say $550, and look what happened. We pushed up, but we got rejected. We did not conquer the momentum barrier, and so guys, should I be suggesting for you to go long? No, we haven't met my conditions, so I'm just going to leave that here just for your consideration. Of course, I can just look to see if there's any kind of, you know, updates that we can consider. No, not really. Just that we do need to hold on to 20,000. I think we can lower this just a bit, that at least for today, because we've kind of lowered the bar basically by not making it on Sunday. You know, we can, if we can just hold on to this 20,000. You know, dollar area by the end of today. Let me just double check. Let's just call that. No, it's still no. You know what? It's still 20,250. I'm sorry. I just made a mistake because I was on the 4 hour. But if we look at the daily for the daily close, which is going to close in 1 hour, of course, this is still valid for the next hour. Wish I was making this video 1 hour from now, but let's just, you know, just use these zones because they should be pretty consistent for the next day as well. And then, of course, let's take a look at the supply, the support and resistance zones that I have. Hey, looky here. We bounced off that middle area that I suggested that it was very possible that we were going to bounce off of. You do see the candle bodies right here on the daily, just kind of bouncing off that kind of middle of this zone. And so we're slowly moving up in this zone. And that is, you know, that is, I mean, I guess technically that's more bullish than bearish, but it just doesn't tell us very much right now. We do have to see if we can recapture our momentum. And then there's probably some type of a limit up here around 21,500. You know, if we did try to reclaim this candle, what caused us to have this bounce if the market is risk off? Well, let's go ahead and go over to the stock market, and you can see what I was pointing out on trading Sunday, right? On the trading Sunday video, what I pointed out is that we had a CME gap on the chart. And let's just go to a smaller time frame. Let's say the 6 hour. And there you can see the gap right there, right? And so what did we do? We just bounced up. We kind of found a little bit of support in this little kind of a notch here, this little kind of wick over here. This is the S&P 500. You can see these little kind of like hang up zones, right? They're not too significant, but we did get a nice bounce off of it right here. And so, you know, this little area that we're in right now, it is, you know, it was possible to get a little bounce. Now, we could have been a little bit deeper. It could have been a little bit higher. But anyway, we bounced from where we bounced. And, you know, we filled that gap. Now that that gap is filled, yes, we do have the possibility to try to reclaim these upper candles and just to retest them. This is a huge institutional candle to the downside on the daily. And so retesting that candle and just making kind of a lower high, lower high, lower high, right? that wouldn't be unusual. Usually these gaps get filled. Usually these kind of exposed candles that have this type of lack of retesting, usually they get retested. And while we can leave some exposed just a little bit, almost all of them get retested in some way to some significant degree. And so, of course, we should have expected a little bit of bounce. But what you don't want to do is just to go full-on bull market mode. Just because you see a little bit of a bounce, you are going to want to use your stop losses and a proper risk management if you're in a downturn, and especially if you're in a macro downtrend, which we are. You just don't want to be going into long positions without extremely good risk management. You can see basically the same thing on the NASDAQ 100, which is that tech heavy index. And so we did have that gap. It got perfectly filled. And look, now we started to come back down again. So that was basically just a matter of filling in the gap there. This week could try to retest those candles. That could push crypto up a little bit. But do I think that this thing is going to go on a bull run just from right here? Not sure, guys. Let's see how we build up support in this area. If it's good support, maybe we could jump up again. But if we end up breaking down and retesting our lows through September, especially as we look for the Federal Reserve to possibly have its last major, interest rate increase, that could bring us back down to testing our lows, making even a lower low, or perhaps establishing a higher low, depending on how ruthless the Federal Reserve is in September. And as I mentioned, Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell came out and was so bearish on Friday, and then also today, Brainard, Federal Chairman, Vice Chairman Lael Brainard, who's not a man, she's a woman. I incorrectly identified her as a man in a previous episode. So apologies, Brainard, for misgendering you. But Brainard came out, and she's basically bearish as well, suggesting that the Fed is going to increase interest rates higher than what the market had expected. So probably we should consider that the market continues to come down. And just jumping back to Bitcoin, of course, that would probably continue to pull Bitcoin's chart down, or at least have it go sideways, assuming that it holds that diagonal that I was showing you on the Alpha Origin channels. But this is pretty ugly. This does look like a bear flag. And so if we do continue to break down, we do have that kind of formation right here that looks a lot like this formation right here. That looks a lot like this formation right here. That looks a lot like this formation right here. And all of those have preceded a pretty nasty drop. And what I'm suggesting, again, please look at my last Macro Monday video. Really, guys, for your own sake, watch that and do consider that the next macro low could possibly be the real low. Okay. Just food for thought, just something to think about. Okay, don't go by one indicator, don't go by one signal, but just food for thought while everyone else is being super bearish and scared and crying to their mommies, right? We're going to try to be just neutral. We're not going to be perma bulls. We're not going to be perma bears. We're going to be clever little alpha monkeys and just do our best to navigate this market, okay? Guys, one thing that I didn't notice in the Sunday trading episode that I made was just how much interesting Ethereum's chart was looking in terms of a possible pump here. And so, of course, we do see this engulfing candle on the daily on Ethereum. That's an interesting look. So we are going to be just following this up, on a Tuesday and a Wednesday, just to see if maybe we get some type of a temporary turnaround, something like that, some type of reaction in the market before perhaps a continuation of a push to the downside. you know, this just looks like a little bit of sideways action that we may be facing. You know, on the daily, it doesn't look that strong. But, you know, overall, you know, this isn't the worst candle to be putting in here. And on a Bitcoin, one thing that I had here that I didn't report properly on the trading Sunday is that we did have a 4-hour God signal. Now, the 4-hour is not a good signal to be using for these things. You can see the last 4-hour, you know, quote unquote God signal that I got here on my oscillators. It was basically a 5% move. So we're getting another one right here. We're starting to turn up on our ADX and these different type of indicators, right? And so we did get a nice 4% move. Could that be 5%, 6%, whatnot? Yeah, sure. That would be in line with the previous quote-unquote God signal. But again, these 4-hour signals, they're not very strong. And so what we're going to be looking for is still that continuation of our volatility on the daily, which looks like it's having a little bit of a flip right now, okay, on the 24/7 exchanges. But on the professional exchanges, we do see just continuation. And so that volatility is probably going to start pinching off soon. You know, we're just not there yet. So not ready to really call any type of change in the market. This looks like a little bit of a sideways action to me. You can see this is still very bearish, ADX, all of that. Just my indicators are just looking like, a little bit of sideways. Maybe we could get a pump, you know, in a few days, maybe in a week, you know, maybe next week's going to be a really good week, or maybe at the end of this week. But I'm just going to continue to monitor that. Who knows? Maybe we turn around Tuesday, Wednesday, depending on how the stock market goes. But I already showed you stocks. So, you know, just keep these things in your mind, okay? Like, we don't have to just fall to hell. Again, guys, again, there was a reason why on Sunday I was showing you these support zones, right? These support zones that we're in, and that's because, I'm on CME. Let's see, going over to the 24/7 exchanges. Populate, there we go. The reason why I was showing you how I do my horizontals is because while I typically are using EMAs and diagonals, you know, this is what, you know, my style of horizontals look like. And look, we are perfectly bouncing from that zone. So we are at support, guys. We're at support. It's not that easy to just break through support. I mean, we did it when we were just really crashing down, but just in regular price action, it's not that easy to break down through support. So all that discussion of these lower levels, whatnot, that's only contingent upon breaking down, guys. And we still have a chance to recapture this momentum, okay? So just, again, don't be a perma bear, don't be a perma bull, just be a clever little alpha monkey and just to trade what we see on the chart. And what we saw on the chart was we're at support and that we have this critical area, right, that we need to conquer that 20,500 minimum, holding on top of 20,000, like very, very securely. This looks very weak, but we need to get above that securely and then above 20,500 very quickly, securely, in order to have any chance of momentum to perhaps testing this resistance. And then we're going to face resistance, right? We're going to face resistance there. Guys, and then ultimately we have this resistance we haven't been able to conquer, right, in this move at all, multiple attempts. And so if we go for one more attempt, right, because we don't have to just think about the downside, we can also think about the upside. This is a market, it goes up and down, right? So we have to think both ways, think about where we could possibly take our profit at. If we don't succeed at achieving our momentum, then if we get a pump from here, then we take some profit right here. If we get on top of here, then we take some profit up here. If we get on top of here, then we take some profit up here, right? Or maybe at the top of this breakdown candle, right? Somewhere up there, somewhere in the middle here. You can see we've got kind of like support that we bounced off of. Just this type of daily levels, right? The lines that you see on your chart are the weekly and monthlies. Are the main weekly ones primarily, and then just a couple dailies in the area that we're at. Guys, apologies for my voice. Again, as I've mentioned in the last couple episodes, I am very sick. So apologies for the voice. Let's see, just going over to, good old KDA, we do see this beautiful candle. We did have some indication that there could be the chance to push through this diagonal. What was previously support had to become resistance. And hey, Kadena fam, I mean, great job. You're doing something which very few coins are doing right now. Almost no coin has been able to achieve what Kadena has just achieved, which is basically they tested that diagonal, got rejected, and then look at how flat this is. This is a triple bottom, at least on the dailies. This is a triple bottom, right, which has just then pushed up and broken that diagonal. And it looks like that the Kadena fam wants to attempt to reclaim this diagonal. And then the next goal would be to reclaim this horizontal, basically at the same point of where the diagonal is. So basically, if we could get another day or two just right in this area, then the Kadena fam will have reclaimed this level bullishly, and that's going to be that's going to reflect very well on Kadena, because then if Bitcoin does have another drop down, it has just an extra layer of security. It has the diagonal, it has this level that it's held very, very well. And I can show you with, for example, ADA. ADA wasn't able to do it, right? It's just getting blocked right there. Maybe it'll push through. It hasn't been able to do it. And you can see these are like lower lows on these daily candles. And then let's look at Zilliqa. Zilliqa isn't even coming close to it. A whole bunch, just a week's worth of lower lows on these daily candles. And then a noble attempt. I mean, this was just an amazing push of 15%, but it just got sold off, guys. It just got sold off very hard. And so look, guys, you're seeing a divergence between Zilliqa, ADA, and Kadena. They all have a totally different look on them. And, so they're all responding differently to the stock market. They're all responding differently to Bitcoin. And it's just because Bitcoin is going in a little bit of a consolidation right now. Okay, so that means that these just unique characteristics of these coins, of these coin armies, of the investors in these things, they are going to show a little bit more of their own character while Bitcoin is going sideways, right? And then, guys, what was I saying? That the VIX was most likely to come back down to fill in that gap that it had, just like the stock market. And so while the VIX, which is that volatility that just, as it pushes up, it's bad for trading, but as it falls down, it's good for trading. Let's go to the 4 hour. And what you can see is that, this last weekend and Friday and Monday morning, basically it opened up super high, leaving a gap. That gap has now gotten filled, which allowed for good trading today as the VIX came down. Remember, VIX coming down is good for trading. But now that that gap's been filled, sort of like it got filled over here, right? This gap got filled and then it pumped up. Well, there's a high likelihood that we're going to continue to pump up, okay? So let's just watch this space. There is some resistance here. You can see these wicks. You can see there is some resistance. And so maybe this thing could go sideways or something. But, just watch this space. I think that good move has basically played out. And now we're just back to watching, okay? Like the freebie, that gap fill, which is the freebie to have a good day of trading today, that freebie is gone. Now we have to be on high alert again. And look at the DXY, the US dollar. What happened is it just had a pullback. I'm not sure what the response or what was the cause of this in the market, but it could be that we're basically looking at a bull flag, right? Of a bull flag that basically had a breakout bullishly and then a retest of the breakout. See what I'm saying? Oh, and then you can see my red line here. This has now been changed to support. Wow, look at that bounce. perfect bounce off of that red line. Look at that bounce to the dollar, to the absolute penny, actually. And we basically have caught that support. And so this thing could continue to push up, okay? That could be a fake out to the downside. So that easy trading that you got today as the dollar strength came down, allowing other assets to gain strength against it, such as crypto, that freebie is now gone. That retest is over. And so now we have to be on high alert for the dollar potentially to pump back up. And I would guess the same thing is happening in USDT. Yep, hey guys, what was I saying in the Sunday trading episode? I was saying that we had pumped up here. There was a good chance that we were going to break down to this mid-level, right? I had all of these lines red previously. I just made it look more like a kind of range right now. And so you can see that we came back down to this mid-level, probably going to bounce off of that, okay? Now, you do see we have these big, long movements, across this range. So it is possible that we break all the way back down. I just don't think that's likely. You do see some pretty strong bounces here. So, let's just follow. Again, we're just on high alert for USDT dominance now. The easy trading of USDT, the easy trading of the dollar, the easy trading of the VIX, that volatility, all of them had pullbacks today, which made trading conditions good for crypto. But tomorrow and for the rest of the week, we can't guarantee that they're going to have those pullbacks. And so while I was suggesting that we could have these pullbacks on Monday, and we pretty much nailed that, right? Like, this just crossed the gap perfectly. It's just unclear what's going to happen for the rest of the week. So be careful Tuesday and Wednesday as the market chooses its real direction. Now that all these gaps have been filled, now that the ranges have been retested, now that the breakouts have been retested, okay? We're looking for possibly continuation on this move. And that is what the Bitcoin professional exchange is suggesting in its volatility. As I was pointing out on the daily, it does suggest potentially continuation on that move, which has been to the downside, okay? So guys, either consolidation, just kind of going sideways, just kind of putting in a little bit of a floor here, maybe if we want to test to the upside, or possibly more downside, in my opinion, okay? And then you guys know the key levels that I've marked out here that we have to be aware of, right? We're in our support zone. We have our resistance zone up here at the 21.7-ish. And then we really have to recapture our momentum of 20,250. And we have to secure 20,550 as soon as possible in order to just have some bullish momentum and change around that volatility perspective, okay? Some guys are talking about the 2-day volatility. So let me just check out the 2-day signal. That one is still expanding to the downside. Let's see for the professional exchange. This one's interesting. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, we just have to watch it. This could be consolidation, just kind of choppiness, or it could be expansion to the downside, or perhaps even up. We will watch this 2-day signal. Thanks to Crown's Crypto Cave for that insight. I'll be looking at the 2-day as well. Guys, gonna wrap it up there. That's your alpha for the day. Stay safe and happy trading.